Genesis chapter 1, verse 26.
Amen. Then God said, and now we will make human beings. They will be like us and resemble us. They will have power over the fish, the birds, and all the animals, domestic and wild, large and small.
Is it okay? Did you hear that?
Yes.
Everybody, close your Bible, listen to her. Let her read it again. Close your own Bible and listen with your ears. Repeat it.
Then God said, and now we will make human beings. They will be like us and resemble us. They will have power over the fish, the birds, and all the animals, domestic and wild, large and small.
It's all right. God said, let us make human beings so that they will resemble us, then they will have power over other created things. Number one, they will resemble us. You are created to resemble God. We are created to resemble God. Every human being is created to resemble God. Help me ask your neighbor, do you know you are created to resemble God? Now we are going to come back to this verse. But if you go closer, that is the part two, is the promise or the blessing or the benefit that comes from resembling God. And that benefit is that man will now have a power over every other thing that God created. Therefore, every effort we make to resemble God, to be like God in truth and in spirit, in character, in morality, the more we resemble God, the more powerful we become as children of God. In this teaching, our prayer is that God will help us to exactly be as He made us to be through Christ the Lord.
Amen.
Father, we thank you for this opportunity, even as we share your word, even as we discuss. Give us the grace, give us the understanding that all glory, O God, will return unto you through Christ the Lord.
Amen.
Shall we be seated in the presence of the Lord? Our topic for discussion says, what is our topic? Catch the fox that spoil the vines. Catch the fox. Fox, F-O-X. Catch. Grapple. Handle. The fox that spoil the vines. And is taken from Song of Songs, or Songs of Solomon, chapter 2, verse 15. Before we go to the text, this is a dinary program that our leaders have organized to help us deal with anything that is tampering with the image of God in our lives. Anything that is making us not to resemble God as is the will of God right from beginning. That is the reason for this program. That is what here. So this program is a program of preservation, to preserve us to the state God wants us to be. It's a program of restoration in case there is any fox, in case there is anything that has tampered with the will of God, with the desire of God, with the design of God for us, that we shall be restored to become exactly who God made us to be. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now, let us look at our text. Song of Solomon, chapter 2. Somebody read for us, verse 15. Song of Solomon, 2:15. Hallelujah.
Songs of Songs, chapter 2, verse 15. And it says, catch for us the foxes, the little foxes that ruin the vineyard.
Catch for us the foxes, the little foxes that ruin the vineyard.
Our vineyard.
Is okay. Catch for us the little foxes that ruin, that spoil, that destroy the vineyard. That is our request. That is our prayer. That is our expectation. In this meeting, we are going to expose, we are going to discover the little foxes that spoil the vineyard of God. The vineyard of God is the children of God. According to Isaiah 5, he said, people of Israel, you are my vineyard. But what are the foxes that spoil this vineyard? What is a fox? In the first place, literally, a fox is a wild animal. When we talk of a wild animal is an animal that cannot be easily tamed, that cannot be easily controlled, that cannot be easily subdued. A wild animal is an enemy to man. The man that seeks to attack man, the man that seeks to harm man. Therefore, the foxes in our lives, in our destiny, is anything or anybody that tries to harm our destiny, to destroy our destiny, so that we will not be who God made us to be. Do you understand? Do you understand? Now, where we started our journey is Genesis chapter 1 and verse 26. And it says that God said he wants to create human beings that will resemble him. God wants us to resemble him. God created us and loved us and made us his children to be like his. How is God? God is good. How is God? God is great. How is God? God is holy. How is God? God is wonderful. How is God? God is powerful. How is God? God is good looking. God is glorious. God is gracious. And so God said, let our own children be like us. Don't you understand that if a goat gives child birth to a child, the child of a goat is called a kid, which means a small goat. He will just be like the mother. Goat, if a snake gives birth to a child, the snake, that child's snake, will be very long or very tall, as long as a snake. Why? Because it is given birth to a, by a snake, meaning it resembles a snake. If a tree reproduces another tree, you see that that small tree will just be like the mother tree. Why? It is like father, like son, like mother, like child. And so, in Genesis chapter 1, when God created man, he gave man the blessing, he gave man the favor, he gave man the grace, he gave man the capacity to be like God, to resemble God in power. God is powerful. In character, God is holy. God is good. God is wonderful. God is merciful. Everything God had, he gave to man, and man was doing well. Man was in charge. Man was in control. Man was powerful. Remember, he said, let us make man to be like us, so that they will be in charge. The more you are like God, the more you are in charge. So Adam in Genesis chapter 1, in Genesis chapter 2, was like God, and so was in charge, controlling every other created thing. But one day, somebody say one day. I shall never say never. One day. Now something happened one day. What is it that happened one day? There was an enemy of God, an enemy of humanity, called the devil, called the Satan. Satan was not happy that man was happy. Satan was not happy that man resembles God. Satan was not happy that man was representing God. Satan was not happy that God handed everything he made over to man. And so Satan decided to rob man. That means to cheat man. That means to deceive man. That from man, that thing that God has given man. And so he came in a gentle way. He came as a friend. And man began to talk to him as if he's a person that has concern, and was able to deceive Eve, and through Eve, deceive Adam. And through that, in Genesis chapter 3, we see what is called as the fall of man. Man fell from grace to grass, from favor to fever, from breakthrough to breakdown. That was the origin of weaknesses, sicknesses, frustration, intimidation, harassment, non-achievement, barriers, obstacles, barricade. Man became a weak person instead of the powerful person that God made. God was not happy. What will God do? God said, no problem. You devil, you are one in against man. But the child of this woman will still come to teach you and cross your head. That is part two. But now we are looking at what the devil has done to man. The devil came to do what? To reduce man from where God placed man. And that is the summary of our teaching today. The force we are talking about is anything that wants to pull you down. Anything that wants to reduce you from the image of God we have, from the glory of God we have, from the grace of God we have, from the anointing that God has created you. When you are a child of God, you are happy, you are bubbling. But there is somebody who is not happy. He came through the serpent. Today, we are looking at the forces. The devil came through serpents. Today, he may not come through serpents. He may come through, your classmates. He may come through the man you call your best friend. He may come through the person that is your enemy. He can come through your father. He can come through your mother. He can come through your uncle. What do you mean? It simply means that anybody can be used to deceive you. And that is why you have to be careful of anybody. Whether in the church, in the house, or in the market, or at school, or in the street. You have to be careful because the devil is moving around looking for somebody to deceive, looking for somebody to devour. But I pray, he will not get you. 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 Jump up, jump up, and shout amen. Spoil the vine, the vineyard of God. Now, creation was very good, but Satan has now released his nature upon humanity. That is that fox we are talking about, that spoiled the vine. The vine is from where you get wine. Wine is sweet. Everybody likes to drink what we call wine, even though it's fruit. Drink. But the vine is what spoils it, so that what is supposed to be sweet will become to be bitter. What are those foxes around us? Number one is, in general, it just stands for the activities of the devil. The activities of the devil. The works of the devil. In Matthew chapter 13, Jesus gave a parable that a man, a farmer, let's use a farmer. Who has a farm? Came and planted maize, planted yam, planted corn. But when the things, it was time for those things to germinate. When they were germinating, weeds began to germinate. The servants were surprised. They say, master, is it not maize? Is it not yam? Is it not grain? Good thing that we planted. How come there are weeds? Jesus said in Matthew chapter 13, verse 38, and the enemy has done it. Everything you see on earth today going wrong is because there is an enemy. Somebody who does not want you to enjoy fellowship with God. Somebody who does not want you to enjoy friendship with God. He does not want you to have a good relationship with God. That is the devil. The devil is not doing this work alone. He is doing it through many people that we call agents of darkness. And their work is to spoil the vine. These agents of darkness is what we have come to tell you to beware, because they are everywhere. They can come in form of a friend. A sister was in my house 5 days ago, I think. She was complaining about her husband. This man, I don't understand, because I'm but you courted. You did courtship before you married. She said, no, we only knew about photos for 1 month when we married. I said, what happened? So I only escorted a friend to their house. I only went with a friend to their house. He said, before I know it, I thought I discovered that I was alone in the room with him. I thought I discovered everyone disappeared, and I was alone with him in the room. I thought because he went with her own friend to somewhere. And that was what led to pregnancy. Sorry, that they marry that man. She said, only met new to just that once. That's what I'm talking about. You have to be careful about the person or persons you call your friends. Tell your neighbor, be careful. So, there are unbelievers. There are people who are agents, the fox. When you see them, they are like agents of light, but they are agents of darkness. Do you know there are many small, small children who belong to one secret group or the other, secret society, where they do bad, bad things. Yet, some of them even come to church. Some of them are in school. They may even be in a class. One sister told us a story some years back when we are doing deliverance. And she was telling us, I was asking her, how did she join the group? He said, the person that initiated her also initiated their integrated science teacher, their teacher in school. He said that every time they are in school, that teacher used to punish that small girl well, that other people don't know why the teacher is always punishing that girl well. He said, but they that belong to that secret group, they know. Why? He said, in that their secret group, that small girl is a queen. So when they go for meeting in the night, she used to punish their school teacher. So when they go to school in the day, the school teacher will punish her. Very small, innocent looking. But in the spirit, because of her sin, she's a queen there. We have to do that one deliverance to bring her out because she opened up. Tell your neighbor, open up.
Open up.
Where is the devil trying to deceive people? So that place God prepared for you, you will not get there. There are many people you see walking on the street, but they have evil minds. They have evil intentions. They can call, tell you, come, let us go for message, go for visit. You don't know that they have something in mind. Did you hear that some children's head we are cut off? Why? Because somebody was being paid 20,000 naira to bring their head. And instead of calling small, small children, he paid another person who will bring his friends. As if they are going, lead me to somewhere. When you enter the room, only he will come out. He will not come out. That are the foxes, part of the foxes that are spoiling the vine. What are you trying to say? Beware of what is happening. You don't have to follow people to do what is wrong, because they are agents of darkness and you are agents of light. Tell your neighbor, you are agents of light. Small, small children today are doing what things that are not good to hear, things that are not good even to talk about. Small, small children, teenagers, will look at a man and say, if you mess up, I will deal with you. It's not that talking to a man, if you mess up, I will deal with you. It's not saying telling you, I will deal with you because he has power. But there are people, they are secret cult members, cults. And they say, whatever happens, we will defend you. And that's why it goes about looking for trouble. Some of them are even come and be looking for a trouble in school. See, just they make you prevent. You have to be careful so that they don't get you into their midst. That is why your approach has deceived many children. Anything you see, they want to eat. Anything you see, you want to eat, you should not be so. Control your appetite. Tell your neighbor, control your appetite. The things that are happening in our generation today, they are not good to mention at all. Because agents of darkness are everywhere. There are some people that they will program something and put it in YouTube, put it in Facebook, put it in social media. And you know what they teach there? How they do bad things. And there are many children who will carry their father's phone, carry their mother's phone, and go and hide and begin to watch what they are not supposed to watch. Not knowing that you are deceiving yourself. They are laughing, are you doing it? Not knowing that you are playing into the hands of foxes. You know, I call you a fox is a wild animal, enemy of humanity. Difficult to control. Just the moment you start it, it becomes a habit. Once it is a habit, you know, we find it difficult to stop it. So the earlier you understand it and run away from it, that is why we have to be obedient to our teachers, obedient to your parents. Hello? Do you know that we have foxes in schools? Foxes in schools. Some of them are your teachers. Some foxes are teaching you in school. What does that mean? They take you by your corner and they are doing to you what is wrong. And they will tell you, if you tell your parents, we will kill you or you will die. You will know that they are deceiving you. Tell your neighbor they are deceiving you. The fox. The fox. Run from the fox and go and tell your father and tell your mother or your guardian. Nothing will happen to you. Why? Because they are foxes. They have come to spoil the good things God is doing in your life. Praise the Lord. Apart from cultism that is running in school, today, many people are doing what you call evil governance. How can you see a young girl, a young boy of 5 years, 10 years, understanding what is called below the covenant? My sister was in my house, did this week or last week. That's me what to do. It's called that their sister and the young man had a blood covenant that if you don't marry me, they will die. If I don't marry them, I will die. Then to say, what do they know about covenant? Praise God. The worst of it is that you know where they met themselves on Facebook. That young man is living in Abuja. The sister is there in the East. But they met in Facebook. I love you past my father, you know. You think that it's coming from the person's heart. Most of them are there, are saying it just to deceive you, just to confuse you. And that is why today, we have to begin to see them as a marks of the force that you are the one away from. Tell your neighbor, run away from them. Demonic manipulation. When the devil begins to tell you to hurt your father, a mind suggests it to you, or somebody in the school tells you, when my father beats me, I do him like this. When my mother beats me, I do her like this. If you beat them back, if you hurt them, they will not beat you again. That person is an agent of darkness. He's not an example, he's a fox. So I say fox.
Fox.
Run from some people. Because they are foxes that spoil your good character. The person may be your best friend or may present themselves as your best friend. When they come giving you such wrong suggestion, you have to run. Tell your neighbor, run. Ask your neighbor, are you sure you're not stealing? How did it to school every day. Get now to school every day. And you are not the I will think that what he's doing is the right thing. You should be the one to influence them to do the right thing. Don't follow the multitude. To do what the multitude is doing, do the right thing. Tell your neighbor, do the right thing. Because your friend is coming to tell you not to school, you begin to steal your parents' money.
You begin to steal
your money in school just for you to buy something. Not food, is something that will spoil your life, is something that will spoil your destiny. And that is why anybody that is encouraging you to be picking your mother's money, to be picking your father's money, that person is not doing you well. Run away from such person. Run away from such people. Because they are foxes. Tell your neighbor, they are foxes. In our class are the people that tell truth. Many of us tell lies as if we are drinking a cup of water and going to go back. Your eyes are shining, shine. You do not even believe your eyes. You just tell lies without even thinking what you are. So tell lies is one of the evidence that a fox has entered your vineyard. That a fox is spoiling your vine. Many children today don't tell truth to their father. They don't tell truth to their mother. They don't tell truth to their elder brother, to their elder sister, to their even younger ones. They tell lies left, right, and center. How many of you come to church and what message is going on? You are busy preaching your devil. Causing distraction. Is that the image of God you are? Is that how God wants you to behave? Causing distraction in the church. Preaching somebody, throwing stone, carrying somebody, hiding spider, hiding people's spider. You think you are doing actual fun. That is how it starts to be agents of distraction. Someone say, God forbid.
God forbid.
Someone say, God forbid.
God forbid.
So that from today, we will continue to do the right thing. So that from today, we will continue to do the right thing. Can we talk about obedience and disobedience? How many children are disobeying their parents? How many children are disobeying their parents? No, that should be a question. The right way are not disobeying because many are disobeying. The person by your right hand is disobeying. The person by your left hand is disobeying. Everybody is disobeying. The question is, will you continue to disobey? Ask, will you continue to disobey? It is better for your mother to beat you. If you tell truth, that for your mother not to beat you and to tell lie. You know why? If you tell truth, even if your mother beats you, God will still be happy with you. Because it means you resemble God. That Genesis 1:6 is a truth in your life. He said, let us make human beings to resemble us. And God is a truthful God. Jesus said, I am the way, I am the life, I am truth. But if you tell lies, and you deceive your father, deceive your mother, and they did not beat you. Will you deceive God?
No.
So God will not be happy with you, and the devil will be happy with you. That means the devil, the fox, is now manipulating you. Someone say, God forbid.
God forbid.
Ephesians chapter 6, from verse 1 to 3, talks about obedience, respect to your parents, and the elderly ones, and says such that your tears will be.
Before we wrap up, we also look at the things the fox afflict us. There are many children of God who are sick.
And what do we need to do? We have to deal with them. Somebody shout to fire.
Fire.
Somebody shout to fire. bad habit, every bad habit you have is a sign that the fox is trying to destroy your life. Do you know there are small, small boys who brag? Why do they brag that they can smoke? Smoking is it a good thing? Even in adverts, the federal government said that those who smoke will die before their time. They will die young. Isn't it? Yet you see children of God, small, small children who are bragging, even though they know their father is not smoking. Not smoking. But because of what you call peer group, they follow the foxes that spoil the vineyard, their vines, and you see their man saying, you know, and nothing can happen. And they are proud that they are doing what is wrong. Some of you are imitating some unbelievers who draw things on their hands and their legs. What do you call tattoo? Tattoo is not, is it of God? Is it the image of God?
To God. You have to live your lives in a way that God will be glorified. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You may not have time to gather, but it is time to catch the thief. What do we do? What do we do? When you discover the area you are not measuring up, you have to reject it, you have to renounce it. Sometimes, you see small, small children, the way they dress is not okay. Young girls dressing to expose their body. That is wrong. Their body is the image of God. It should be kept holy and protected. You see some small, small boys cover, they will not hold it. The cover of their shirt, sadly. Those things we see, people will know them as bad people. You know that they are bad people. And we are still imitating what bad people are doing. People in primary school today talking about boyfriend, talking about girlfriend. Is it good?
No.
It's not good. These are things. There are people you know, even in your class, you call them bad guys. In your class, you call them bad guys. Yet you want to imitate them to do what they are doing. Is it good?
No.
Those are the foxes we are talking about that we should try to avoid. Do you know that some of your mates did not leave school because they were expelled, that before exam they were found to be pregnant or that they molested somebody and they were expelled because they did not do what they are expected to do, and that brings shame to their family, shame to their Christianity. Is it good?
No.
What are we going to do?
For teaching, the way out, number one, a life of separation. A life of separation. What do you mean by a life of separation? 2 Corinthians chapter 6, if you read verses 14 through 18, he says we are not the same. There's a difference between a believer and a non-believer. There's a difference between light and the darkness. 2 Corinthians chapter 6 from verse 14 to 18. He said, do not be unequally yoked together with unbelievers. Who is your best friend? What type of advice does she give you? What type of advice does he give you? He said, do not be unequally yoked together. That means don't mingle together with them as if you are equal. Because you are not equal. You are the image of God. Tell your neighbor, you are the image of God.
You are the image of God.
Put your hand, say, you are the image of God.
You are the image of God.
The second thing is the renunciation. As you identify the areas where you are not living well, it's not for you to cry, it's not for you to be ashamed of yourself, it's for you to renounce them, for you to reject them. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 9 through 11. Say, those who live in immorality, those who are disobedient, will not inherit the kingdom of God. Those who do bad things, those who join the group of foxes, will not be the kingdom of God. 1 Corinthians 6, 9 to 11.
Finally, the way out is a life of the Spirit. to live in the spirit, according to Galatians chapter 5, verse 16. Galatians chapter 5, verse 16, then verses 22 and 23. A life controlled by the Spirit of God. To allow the Spirit of God to lead you. That is what we do right in the Spirit seminar when we mature. So that the Spirit of God will help us to direct us, will help us to know the truth, to live the truth, will help us to serve God in spirit and in truth, will help us to be a blessing to our parents, to our generations.
Will help us not to disappoint our fathers, our mothers, our guardians, not to disappoint our teachers, not to disappoint the charismatic, not to disappoint the church of God, not to disappoint the body of Christ. Somebody say, I will not disappoint God.
I will not disappoint God.
I will not disappoint
God.
Stand on
your feet, stand
on
your feet, stand
on
your feet.
Have your two hands put on your head. Come. I am a child of God.
I am
the image of God.